job with Gino these last couple of years. He deserves a lot of credit. He's one of the best trainers in our sport. Robert Garcia, say a few words. Robert?
Good night to everybody. You know, we, once again, obviously didn't take the decision, but I am, you know, very proud to say that, you know, Gino Maidana, a one-dimensional fighter who nobody ever thought would be in this position, has fought Mayweather twice, and has been able to do what he's done in both fights. I am very, very happy that everybody came to support Mayweather for giving us the opportunity. We are blessed to be where we are right now, and this is just the beginning. I think there's so many big things for Chino in the future. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, so we'll open up the questions.
Chino, first question for you. Do you think that you gave a blueprint, even though you didn't win either of the fights, to other fighters that may face Floyd in the future to be able to beat him, showing him the way you attack him?
Yo creo que sí, que se le puede ganar. Hay que pelear con
el doctor.
Yes, that's true. I think he's beatable. I think you have to attack him more and more, and when you attack him, he doesn't really know what to do.
Chino, I wonder, he landed 58% of his power punches and 51% of his punches overall. You know, so he had a significantly higher percentage landed punches than you. Do you think it was the fact that his speed was too much and you couldn't hit him as much as you would want to because that it initiated that 166-128?
No, para nada. No, pude contragolpearlo y también... bueno, es rápido de pierna, pero lo pude golpear.
No, not at all. It didn't bother me. You know, I was able to counter him, actually. I was able to counter him, and he's very fast on his feet, I'll tell you that.
Two other things. Can you explain from your standpoint what happened in the center of the ring in the eighth round when it appeared you bit him?
La verdad que yo en ningún momento sentí que lo mordí, no. Sí me metí a los dedos en el ojo y no, yo no sentí que lo mordí.
No, not at all. I didn't bite him. That didn't happen. I didn't bite him. I think that he poked my eye. I did feel that when he had his glove in my face, but no, I didn't bite him.
And then, Mr. Garcia, I just wanted to ask you, when you're in the corner and you know Mayweather's landing at a much higher percentage, does that affect you at all, or do you feel like Chino's pressure made the difference? Because, you know, the connect percentage was so much vastly different.
Well, we were asking Chino to put a lot of pressure. Obviously, that's the way we're effective. We landed punches when we had Floyd in the corner, so we just kept reminding him to put pressure. And, you know, the fight was a close fight, and Floyd was doing his job. You know, he's been the best for the last 10 years. What can we do?
Okay, more questions, Dan.
Hey, Gino. Robert, the question for him, or whoever's going to translate. He's now had two fights, high-profile fights with Floyd Mayweather. He went the distance. He was competitive, certainly, in the first one. Maybe not as much so tonight, but still, fun fight to watch. What does he think it does for, even though he has two losses in a row, what it does for him going forward with so many other, quality fighters in the weight class that he thinks nothing really exciting fights in advance?
Excuse me.
And make money for himself.
Sorry. Excuse me, please. Sorry.
Yo
creo que no, me siento muy contento del trabajo que hice. Le he dado batalla a Floyd Mayweather que casi ningún boxeador le ha pegado tanto como le pegué yo.
Look, I'm very satisfied with my performances against him. I did very well, I feel, against him, and I feel that I connected and landed too many punches that the other fighters weren't able to.
Yo creo que no, no sé, pero creo que estoy para pelear con cualquiera.
I think I'm fine. I'm still at the same level. I think I'm ready to fight anybody. I can fight anybody at that level.
With two fights against Floyd and the performances that we did, I honestly, I think Chino's in great position for great fights. There's so many big names out there that that fight in the welterweight division. I'm sure Sebastian Contursia and now I'm gonna, you know, find out something great, great in the future. There's nothing to be ashamed of. We fought the best, and I think we did a great job both times. So we're in great position right now.
Greg,
Chino.
You know, in the first fight, you admitted that you got tired in the second half. How did you feel in the second half of this fight?
En la primera pelea.
Sí, en la primera pelea bajé un poco el ritmo en el quinto round para adelante, sexto. En esta me preparé muy bien, sabía que iba a ser una pelea dura como la anterior y tuve bien 12 rounds.
Yes, you're right. In the first fight, I you know, my rhythm stopped. You know, I slowed down. But in this fight, I felt that I fought hard for 12 rounds, and I felt a lot better.
And I was going to ask Robert, going into those final two rounds, did you think that Maidana may need a knockout or knock him down to get the decision? Did you think it was close? Did you think you were ahead?
No, we knew the fight was close, but we pushed him to finish strong, and that's what he did. He finished strong. I think those last couple of rounds were clearly his. It was a very close fight. It was a very competitive fight. Something, you know, like he just said, like he told you earlier, something that nobody else, you know, great fighters that are going to be in the Hall of Fame haven't been able to do with him. He's been able to do something like that. We're honestly very proud of what we accomplished with Chino.
Did you think it was closer this time around than the first fight?
I think both fights were very close. You know, Mayweather's also a very smart fighter. He fights very well. He boxed really good. You know, that's why he's the best.
Chino, acá Ernesto Rodríguez de Olé.
Okay.
Ya no vamos a estar. Primero un recuerdo. Para todos los presentes hoy en Argentina, ahora empieza el Día del Boxeador recordando el 23 de septiembre de 1921 cuando Luis Ángel Firpo derribó del ring a Jack Dempsey en una pelea, la primera pelea del siglo. ¿Cómo son tus sensaciones de haber vuelto a parar el mundo, de haber estado en el centro de la atención contra el mejor boxeador libra por libra?
The question is, let me go ahead and translate. The question was that it was today in Argentina to celebrate the Day of the Boxer, and that back in the turn of the century, Filippo fought against Jack Dempsey, and it was a big thing in Argentina. How do you feel that you performed today and you fought against the best fighter in the world, pound for pound?
Bueno, muy contento de volver a pelear con Floyd Mayweather y no, muy contento por el apoyo de la gente y bueno, traté de brindar todo lo posible y traté de ganar, pero no pude. Pero bueno, yo creo que espero que le haya gustado a toda la Argentina, a todo mi público, a toda la gente que me apoya.
I'm very happy. I'm very happy with my performance. I gave it my all. I tried to win. I really tried to win. You know, I hope that my fans and my followers are happy with my performance. I did what I could to win, and I came up short.
Chino, ¿cómo te sentís viendo la pelea, viendo que el referee te descuenta un punto por una palanca con la que terminás derribando 50 a Mayweather, y en el round siguiente recibís un golpe limpio, bajo, claro, y Mayweather solo recibe un apercibimiento y no le quitan puntos?
How do you feel? The question is, how do you feel that they took away a point from you? And then the following round, Floyd did, you know, he landed a low blow, and then they just gave him a warning.
Bueno, la verdad que la palanca, yo puse el codo como lo pone él y él se dejó caer. No fue que yo lo tiré ni nada. Y bueno, y ahí el árbitro me descontó puntos que no tendría que haberme descontado.
Well, I mean, when they took away the point from me, I don't think that I did it purposely. You know, I was just trying to get away. He fell on his own. I didn't push him down. But it is what it is.
Y la última es para el Chino y para Sebastián. ¿Se dejó entrever la posibilidad de volver a Las Vegas? ¿Ya tienen alguna propuesta, Chino o Sebastián Contursi?
The question's for Sebastián Contursi. Would you guys consider coming back to Vegas and fighting again?